Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we will build a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless, Active Directory and much more. In our previous video, we were able to combine user and computer authentication by using the machine authenticated role, which is automatically applied in ClearPass. However, I mentioned this is not perfect, and there was a command below the video as well, which mentioned that sometimes the machine authenticated is missed, and that's correct. So that can happen, for example, if you put a device in sleep mode and then wake up again. It could be that the machine authentication is missed at that point and you don't have the machine authenticated role, and that would result users on corporate devices to get into the BYOD role, which is not what we want. As well, this may happen if you have a system that's already signed on and you switch, for example, between the wired and the wireless connection, then it can be that the machine authentication is missed by the ClearPass server and you will end up in the wrong role. The suggested solution from that command was to use the endpoint database and place an attribute in there. And we didn't discuss the endpoint database at all, so maybe it's a good moment to discuss that for this video. If you have the access tracker, you can see here that we have the machine authenticated role. We are user authenticated, but we also see an end host identifier. We can click on it and then we go into the endpoint database. And there you can see the information that's available for this client. And at this point, it's not that much information. This is also where when we start doing profiling, we will see all the profiling data. So it's a central repository where for each of the MAC addresses, we can collect information. We can also add attributes there, either manually or automatically. So if we go into the attributes, we can type an attribute name and we can type any attribute name and we can give it a value and then that will be added. And during the authentication and during the service processing, we can use that attribute for specific things. So this is how you apply it manually, but we can also apply it automatically. And let me show you how you can do that. So if we go into the access tracker, let's see if we have a proper attribute. So in the computed attributes, what we can see is that we have, for example, here the certificate information, maybe the certificate subject common name, that might be a good one to store in the endpoint database. And then we can check during the enforcement if that attribute is there and if it ends on .arubalab.log. And then we can determine that this device was once machine authenticated. Let's bring that to action. We start creating a new enforcement profile of the type ClearPass entity update enforcement. Let's give it a name. WS update domain machine. Let's put a description there. And then under the attributes, we can select endpoints and then the attribute. So by manually adding it, it was automatically added to the database. We can select it from here. And now under the value, what we can do is we can put a placeholder percent curly brace open and then certificate subject CN, exactly like it's shown in the access tracker. So I copied it from there. And then during the enforcement, that will be replaced by that attribute. Next step is that we need to go into the enforcement policy. And in our rules, let's add this enforcement to the machine authenticated rule. So let's go in. Let's add this one. And we can have multiple enforcement profiles. So both we return the machine role and we update the endpoint. Now let's see how that works on the client. Let's sign out so we trigger a machine authentication. We can sign in again. Let's have a look in the access tracker. There we have the machine authentication, and if we click on it, we can see that in the output, the radius response is also an update for the endpoint, the domain machine attribute to the host name as taken from the certificate. So that's the token that's taken from the certificate. And if we check in the endpoint database, we can see as well under the attributes that now the machine name is in there. Next step is that we can use this in our role mapping. Let's go back to our role mapping, go to our mapping rules, and we can create an additional rule where we are checking the endpoint domain machine. So that's the newly added attribute. If it ends with .arubalab.log, then we will assign the WS machine role, which we didn't use before. But now we can use it. See, these are all matches, so we can have multiple matches in here. Let's have a look if this row mapping works now. Trigger a change of authorization for this machine. So we have a re-authentication. That's okay. And we can see the new authentication. And in the new authentication, we can now see that we have the WS machine role. That is because in the endpoint database, we have stored the name of a previous computer authentication and that's pulled out. And that's why this WS machine role is assigned now. Let's now change our enforcement policy to take this into consideration instead of the machine authenticated built-in role. So let's have a look, go to our rules. Then let's take the admin one to test with. Let's edit this rule. And instead of the tips role equals machine authenticated, we can enter tips role equals WS machine. And then we can remove the machine authenticated. And the enforcement of the update domain machine, let's keep it there. Oh, I see also that I have the admin twice here. So that should be help desk. Let's fix that immediately. So let's change this to WS help desk. I've seen this before, but I didn't find the time to fix it. Now we check if we have the WS admin. So the user is in the admin AD group and we have the attribute set on the endpoint database. In that case, we return the admin role. Let's trigger a re-authentication again. And what you can see is that we indeed have the WS admin and the WS machine role. And we see the enforcement profile is WS admin. So the new enforcement does work now, not based on the machine authenticated role, which we still have, but on the WS admin and the WS machine. So if we have once authenticated as a machine, then forever we will be remembered as a domain computer. Note that by marking the endpoint as a domain computer like we do with this endpoint update, that this will stick forever. So unlike the machine authenticated, which will go away after 24 hours, this will stick to the endpoint or to the MAC address forever, which might not be what we want for security reasons, but it does work at least. And why we don't want that is that, for example, if we have these modern docking stations, the USB docking stations, is that the MAC address is tied to the docking station rather than to the computer, which means that if you unplug your corporate computer from the docking station and you plug in another device, it will take the MAC address. And if you have tied the machine authentication to that MAC address, then you can plug in any device and it will be remembered as a corporate machine. There is a solution to that, and that solution is called TEAP, EAP-TEAP. And EAP-TEAP will do EAP chaining and it will combine two different authentication steps in a single authentication. That will allow us to do the computer authentication and the user authentication in the same authentication flow. And that will be more secure than what we have done before, either with the machine authenticated cached role or with the endpoint attribute that we have added in this video. TEAP authentication will be a topic for a future video. I hope you like this video. If so, please press the like button, also comment to the videos and subscribe to our channel.